Should we talk about the five steps that would simplify that workflow? Yeah,
let's share. So the first thing we want to do on any scope is define the why. So as we mentioned earlier, we want to define the BIM uses. Why are we going to...
What's the purpose?
Why are we going to use BIM in the first place? You know, if we have a complex design in this building, then we might want MEP coordination to make sure we find enough constructability issues before we get on site. Then, once we define the why, that'll help us answer the what. Now, what scope is required to do the structural estimate? Is it wall foundation, steel? How much depth do we get into the elements?
Do we need reinforcement, for example? Yep.
That leads us to the level of geometry, the information. So here we're looking at, you know, for structural estimation, we might just need some basic modeled lines or basic components. But once we get into MEP coordination, we might need more information or more detailed information.
Yep. So defining some spaces and blockout zones or hangers and braces.
Right. Defining when is very important because you don't have to spend that time up front and you might not have that information up front. So aligning those expectations would prevent a lot of headache.
Yeah, putting things in the model too soon as well, even though it might have a use at some point, if you put it in too soon, it might cause a lot of rework downstream as well. So understanding this progression is really important, and making sure that you model it once rather than multiple times at multiple levels of geometry is usually the least wasteful, most lean approach to it.
Right. And then within each element, there's information needs. There's information requirements, so the level of information, level of geometry, or even documentation items that you might specify for each element.
Yep, and bundling all of that up into a visual, very intuitive grid type approach is really powerful to be able to understand it and communicate it. And here are more information requirements that might be required.
And then one of the most important things is defining who is responsible. So here we're defining the structural teams to model the structural components, and then we might want to show the handovers as well. So having the architect being responsible for the design of the stairs, but ultimately it's the structural team who will be taking over that model for coordination purposes. So the thickness of the stairs, if it's concrete, if it's steel.
If it's precast, if it's cast in situ, is there some kind of requirement for space to be able to install things or to be able to service them, etc.?
Right. So these are the five simple steps to build a scope, anything from the why, what, who, and how much. If you can answer these questions, you'll definitely be off to a good start. So a lot of great and successful projects come out with very clear scopes, like the one you're seeing now. And, you know, making them visual has been a plus, because if we can avoid what is LOD 200 or LOD 300, and we're just simplifying them into these basic questions, you spend more time having educated conversations, or the right conversations, as opposed to trying to educate others to get on board with the project, or just... less time answering questions and more time doing the work.
I've had some really powerful conversations with some senior executives in companies that they've revealed to us that they haven't really understood other scope or really what BIM could do until they visually identify in this grid. And that was such an aha moment, a big, you know, bell ringing. It was so incredibly powerful for us to hear that that's been something that we've really focused on developing right the way through a workflow.
Yeah, and another example that I needed to share was an owner would always work with the same contractor, and they've been, you know, spending lots of time providing information for almost every component in a model. But when they sat down with them and actually asked them what information is important to some specific elements, they ended up having a 45-minute conversation on the exact scope that they needed, and they started saving hours of time in all of their future projects because they minimized it to 17 parameters, and to, instead of thousands, to only a few dozen equipment that they were really interested in having after at the handover anyway.
But suddenly everybody understands. Yeah. The scope, not just of their own, but also of all of the parties that they're working with. It's an incredibly powerful moment.